Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about the immobilizer diagnostic in case of cranking but no starting. We have some other videos on the channel for the immobilizer system. You can find the link for that video in the video description. In that video, I explained everything about the immobilizer system, all the components, how to do the diagnostic, about the key programming, everything. But there is something very important that was not included in that video because I wanted to explain it in a separate video, and that's actually the communication between immobilizer control unit and ECM. On many cars between IMMO control unit and ECM, there's a communication line for sharing the information, for sharing the key information, and for getting the authorization to ECM to start the car. If anything goes wrong with that communication line, we won't be able to start the engine. For checking the communication line between IMMO control unit and ECM, you can find a wire and check the wire end by end by a multimeter. But sometimes the issue is much more complicated. So using an oscilloscope is going to help you to understand what sort of issues you have. For this video, we're going to use oscilloscope for diagnosing that communication line between IMMO control unit and ECM, which is Kline in this case. And for that, we're going to use this oscilloscope. This oscilloscope is from MICSIG, and this is the model of this oscilloscope that I'm using today. This is a four-channel oscilloscope, but I'm going to use only one channel because the communication network that I have in immobilizer system has only one wire. So I'm going to use only one channel. So we're going to go for finding that wire first on the wiring diagram. Then I set up the oscilloscope to read the waveform. And then I explain to you what's going to happen to the waveform in case of any issues. So by the oscilloscope, you can understand what sort of issues you have. Before starting the video, if you guys haven't subscribed the channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe. You can support us by liking the video or share it with your friends. And if you are interested to learn more about the network, you can find our online courses in the video description. Let's have a look at the wiring diagram first. So what you see is the wiring diagram of immobilizer system exactly for this car that we are working on. Let's identify the components. This one is antenna coil, which is just on the ignition switch. This is immobilizer control module. Majority of the time, this control module is under the dash. For this car is under the dash, it's a little difficult to reach to, so you need to remove the instrument cluster to reach to the control unit. I will show you the location. This one is instrument cluster to show the IMMO warning lights. And down here, we have the ECM. So anytime that you want to start the engine, ECM will ask the immobilizer control unit to send the information and authorization to start the car. If this isn't happening, if ECM doesn't get the authorization, you can crank the engine, but you won't be able to start the car. Look at the IMMO control unit. You have K-line signal, and the other one is the serial signal. That K-line signal is not what I'm talking about. That one is actually between IMMO control unit and, as you see, data link connector, which is DLC or OBD2 connector. That one is used for communication between the scan tool and IMMO control unit. We have another video on the channel that I explained how to diagnose this K-line. You can find that one on the video description. But today we're going to go for that serial signal, which that one is actually a K-line network as well. So IMMO control unit communicates with ECM through that K-line network. So very quickly, if I explain, K-line is a one-wire communication network, which is generally used for communication between a scan tool and some control units, like in this case, IMMO control unit. Sometimes K-line is used for some other purposes, like communication between IMMO control unit and ECM. This is exactly that case. First of all, we're going to go for finding the K-line. And on the oscilloscope, we will see how we can read the waveform and what sort of information we can get for diagnostic purposes. So on the car, as you see, I have removed the instrument cluster to reach to the IMMO control unit, which is that one right at the back. This car is a Kia Rio, but of course, the procedure for diagnostic is very similar on many, many cars. So I'm going to disconnect the connector to find the lean bus because it's much easier to hook up the oscilloscope from here, because during the diagnostic I need to turn the ignition switch on and off a few times. So you can reach to the K-line from ECM side or from IMMO control unit side. So I'm going to disconnect the connector right now. I disconnect the connector. You see the connector right now on the screen. We are looking for pin number 9, as I showed you earlier. it's a blue-black wires, so it's gonna be just right here. And if I look at the back, you see that blue-black wire? Second from the left, that is what we are talking about. So I did back probe that blue-black wire. I'm gonna connect the connector back. So right there, as you see, connector is connected, back probe is right there. So I can go for setting up the oscilloscope to read the waveform. This oscilloscope is very easy to set up. As you see, one end of the oscilloscope probe is connected to channel one. On the other end, I have these two. This is gonna go for picking up the signal on that back probe that I inserted on the K-line on the IMMO control unit. And this is for a good ground. So as you see, oscilloscope probe is inserted already on the K-line. So we have connected the oscilloscope probes. We are ready to read the waveform, because this waveform on the K-line is gonna happen very fast. For capturing, sometimes I do some initial adjustment. Of course, on this one, we have auto set and we have some options that we can select from here that I'm gonna try on some other videos later on. But right here, what we see, we have the voltage setting for channel one, and right now it's on 100 millivolts. 100 millivolt means each division right now on the voltage bar equals to 100 millivolts. We need to remember that on the K-line, the voltage changes between 0 to 12. So 100 millivolt is just too small. We can change the voltage from here. I put it on 2 volts, and the time setting is on 2 milliseconds. I'm gonna change the time setting as well to be able to capture that waveform that I am after. So I'm gonna go for turning on the ignition switch right now. So right now we are getting the waveform from the K-line on immobilizer system. I pause the waveform. We're gonna go for reading the waveform to see what we can get from it. If I go for changing the waveform like this to change the time setting to reach to the very beginning, these were actually the two initial waveforms that we got from the K-line. When you turn the ignition switch on, when ECM receives the ignition on signal, it's gonna send a wake up signal to the immobilizer control unit to make sure if the IMMO is responding. First of all, this is not gonna be for asking for the code, this is the wake up signal. So this section is the wake up signal. So wake up request from the ECM and wake up response from the immobilizer. This is actually what ECM has sent. This is what immobilizer responded back to the ECM. If ECM receives the wake up signal back from the immobilizer, it knows that the immobilizer is responding, and then it's gonna go for data request. So here is the data request from the ECM, and this is the data response from the immobilizer control unit. This is actually the authorization to the ECM to let the ECM start the engine. So basically, if we go back, we have two main sections, wake up section and data section. Wake up signal from ECM, wake up response from the IMMO to ECM, data request from ECM, and data response from the immobilizer control unit. As long as we have the waveform, we want to make sure that there is no abnormality. That's very important for us. We don't want any sort of abnormality on the waveform. If waveform doesn't exist, it means there is something going on that I'm going to explain right now. If waveform exists, but it's giving you all sort of abnormality, again, there is something going on. And the different sections should exist as well. And for reading the voltage on base voltage and down here, we can just go for the cursor. We have the cursor right there. We're gonna go for the horizontal cursor to be able to read the voltage. So we have Y1 that we need to adjust it from here. And Y2 that you can adjust it from here. As you see, Y1 is just right at the base voltage, which is gonna give us almost battery voltage, 11.69. And Y2 is showing us something very close to zero, which is down here. So the voltage change on K-line is between 12 to zero, almost 12 to zero. So if you are reading the voltage and you are getting something very different, there is something going on. For example, if K-line, if this communication network is shorted to ground, you're gonna get no waveform, and the waveform is gonna be constantly at something very close to zero. But this is actually for the wiring issues. Sometimes the problem is from something else, from ECM or from the IMMO control units. So we already know that the waveform should look like this, and we already know the voltage level. But what's gonna happen if, for example, immobilizer is not responding back? Because between these two units which are communicating, If one control unit like immobilizer is not responding back, you won't be able to start the engine. I'm going to make that fault right now. Then we will see how waveform is going to look like if immobilizer is not responding back. For simulating this one, I'm going to disconnect the connector from IMMO control units, but I will keep the back prop connected to be able to read the waveform. So I'm going to turn off the cursor. So immobilizer connector is disconnected. I'm going to run the waveform right now. And look at the waveform when I turn the ignition switch on. So you see the waveform, it's completely different. Let's zoom it a little. So what you see here continuously is just wake up signal from ECM. The waveform is completely different from what we had earlier, because this is only the wake up signal that ECM keeps sending to the immobilizer. And because immobilizer is not responding back, that's why it's not gonna go to the next step for requesting the data. So if you are getting a waveform like this on the immobilizer control system, it means there is something wrong on the IMMO control unit itself. It could be the connector on the control unit, it could be the control unit itself, but we have the idea that the issue is from the IMMO control unit. And if you check the voltage level, it's gonna be very the same. It's gonna be between almost 12 to almost zero. So one more time, immobilizer connector is disconnected. I'm gonna turn the ignition switch on and see how many of those wake up signals we're gonna get from the ECM. Did you see that? ECM sends the wake up signal a few times for the immobilizer control unit, but because it didn't receive any signal, we don't have any waveform here anymore, because ECM is already on the LIM home mode, knowing that IMMO control unit is not responding back. That wake up signal is not gonna show up here all the time. ECM tries a few times. If it doesn't receive any signal back on the wake up phase, it's gonna stop trying. And now I connected the connector back again. So once again, as you see, when I turn the ignition switch on, the waveform is back to normal. We have the wake up signal and data signals. This is actually how a normal waveform should look like when we are doing the diagnostic on immobilizer Kline. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends. If you're interested to watch the other videos that we have for diagnosing the network and for using the oscilloscope for diagnosing the car, please check our channel. And you can, of course, find our online courses in the video description. Thank you very much for watching.